Yeah, my buddy's coming from New Rochelle. Yeah.
And what,
Bobby, I need the packing table.
All right, it's all cat carriers and open stuff now.
Johnny,
Somebody
needs to get...
Go on, it's there.
Good job.
Good job to everybody who did it. You know, this stuff...
Right on top.
You know, we should probably set up a...
My name's Maria Carabello. I'm from Sisters from the Heart and the Mount Vernon Yonkers Elks Lodge in Kiwanis. We joined in with Anthony Scarduzio, who is himself looking for a double lung transplant. He was one of our first responders at 9/11. Again, he tosses everybody else's, his needs aside to help everybody else. He started this, we joined in, and it snowballed, and it's just been the community coming together to help others in need.
And how did you get involved with Dr. Green and...
Dr. Green is part of the Carmel Cubs from the baseball team, and my brother is his son's coach. So he is part of the Carmel Family and Friends Organization.
And where are you going next with this truck?
Next is the YMCA in Tarrytown. Then we will go back to the Mount Vernon Yonkers Elks Lodge in Mount Vernon, finish loading the rest of the stuff there. We have two trucks going and approximately 20 cars, and we're going to caravan down to Breezy Point.
Now, how did the YMCA get involved?
Dr. Green, and we had heard that they had stuff needing to go to Breezy Point. They had no way of getting it down there. We said we'd take it down.
There are a number of things to the back that are food stuff that you've already packed.
Yeah, that's already, that's fine. It's just that we know that that's already been sorted. This has food and other things in it, so I want to sort it so it's separate. That stuff has already been sorted.
Yeah, Maria, initially, as it was coming in, we were trying
that's
to put it in different areas.
It's not for, I have 15 people at the lodge waiting to sort.
I put up on the Rockaway Relief Facebook page the address of the supermarket. You know Anthony stopped accepting donations?
We had no choice.
I know, and...
I'm going to probably wind up having to get another van.
Did you hear about the... No, Mahopac Fire Department's coming to pick up everything he couldn't fit.
Awesome, so Mahopac Fire Department's following us down?
I guess.
Awesome.
Yeah, Anthony, did you put that up on Facebook?
That stuff's got to go.
Anthony just put that up on Facebook.
I was contacted by a friend of mine, Tom Fava, who's my son's baseball coach, letting me know that a friend of ours who we're busy fundraising for, because he was injured at Ground Zero after the 9/11 attacks, and is on oxygen and needs a double lung transplant, was himself giving back to the community by organizing a relief effort for, originally we thought, Staten Island. Then we found out that Staten Island was already getting more than enough donations that they could handle. So we started looking at the Breezy Point and the Rockaways. And Tom got his sister Maria involved, who had contacts with the Kiwanis Club and Sisters of... Sisters from the Heart, an organization down by her. And this thing has literally just exploded. The tropical fruit salad. I got the silly idea to send out an email to my incredible clientele on Thursday afternoon, and everything you're seeing loaded into this truck right now came from my clientele in one day. This is a community effort. There are people that are desperate for help, and I'm proud to be a part of a group that has decided to mobilize and see what we can do to help them out.
Here we come, Rockaway!
Okay, we're
pull all the way down.
I think you pull right on the fence here, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Here, Jay, take this a big case.
Good afternoon. My name is Melissa Weaver, and I'm here at the Family YMCA at Tarrytown with my son and our volunteers. We have collected many items to go to Breezy Point today for Sandy hurricane relief. We have non-perishable foods, blankets, toiletries, many, many items, because as far as we understand, Breezy Point is in desperate need of items as FEMA has not made their way out there yet. So we are very thankful to everyone in the community for coming out and donating so many items and helping everyone in Breezy Point.
That's it. And I have another van on its way to the
Wow.
Garage.
This is
brilliant.
Awesome.
This is so brilliant.
Came out.
How did you get the donations?
All the donations began coming in Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and today. They are from members of the YMCA and members of the community. I put the word out on Facebook, through our website, and through word of mouth throughout the YMCA.
And what people donated?
We have clothing, we have diapers, wipes, cleaning supplies, first aid supplies, non-perishable foods, shovels, rakes, brooms, work gloves, cat food, dog food, cat litter.
You mentioned one of your staff was involved with the Red Cross and helped coordinate the effort with the Y.
Christina Kareem is a volunteer for the American Red Cross, and she also was able to obtain cleaning kits and had them donated to us.
And how did that work with the COC?
The COC had started a shelter effort, and I had put her in touch with the COC when we found out that they were going to do shelter operations.
So now the position of the YMCA with COC, what's going on?
The COC has now officially closed their shelter. It was the local shelter for the community.
And now the workload is on the YMCA and...
Just to get donations to go specifically to Breezy Point.
Or both.
And those packs of gloves?
Antonio.
Two. Give me the smaller pack.
It's been there too.
We're gonna get a second cup and we'll go back now. My brother was gonna grab this one.
Because a lot of that's kid stuff.
All those bags that are coming in yet?
Yeah. Not made strong.
It's gonna be rough for you to
Client that's coming up to Carmel, to Ossining, to get more stuff because they ran out of room up there.
Okay.
So he's going to, if he has room, they're going to swing by here and pick up this stuff.
It'll be right at the front desk.
Okay. On the way to Breezy Point!